I ordered this drone from Banggood website. Link is given in the description. You can visit the link if you want to know the details of the product. It reached me here in Pakistan in about 11 days. Packaging looks good. Let's open it. This foam is an extra protection to prevent it from any damage during the shipping process. Let's open it further. So, here is the main box of the drone. It looks pretty nice. Let's open it. Yeah, so here it goes. It's packaged in a plastic case. Upper part of the case is transparent, through which drone can be seen. It looks so small in hands. Let me see if it actually fits in my front pocket. Oh yes, it fits there. That's why it is nicknamed as a pocket drone. Great man, it really is a pocket drone. Let's see what else is in the box. These are instruction booklets in two different languages. One is in English and the other one is in some other language that I can't tell about. 8 extra propellers in case your original ones are broken. A small screwdriver for the propeller screws. Battery charging case and cable. And here is the 1400 milliampere hour battery. I think there is nothing else left in the box. Yeah, there's nothing else. Some instructions are shown on the box too. A closer look of the tiny screwdriver. Let's take a closer look at the drone. These tiny holes in the top part are for connecting the accessories if you want. Accessories include spotlight, boom boom gun, etc. I haven't ordered any of the accessories though. This is a large slot in the back for battery. Some sensors are there in the lower part. And the camera is in the front here. It can record videos in 4K at 30 frames per second and can take 13 megapixel images. Let's spread open its arms. Its propellers feel delicate. Be gentle with them. Its design is very sportish and attractive. It's available in a few more colors too, like camouflage and silver. I like the orange one though, maybe because it gives more sportish feel, like an orange Lambo. Anyway, these are two small slots on the right side of the drone. One is for inserting a micro SD card, while the other one is for inserting a USB cable. These are the bottom sensors and the power button. In the next few days, I'll be using and testing this drone, and then I will be able to share my experience with you. Spread the arms. Insert the battery in the large back slot. This is the power button in the lower part. Press it for 5 seconds. When the drone starts, you will see green lights in the front and orange lights in the rear. The drone will beep for a few seconds and its propellers will show slight jerky movements. After a few seconds, you will hear a long beep. This long beep means the drone is now ready for connection with the smartphone. Let's connect it with my Android smartphone now. Turn on the Wi-Fi. Press on Wingsland. Enter the password. Password is written on the side of the drone. It is usually 123456789 or Wingsland. For my drone, password is Wingsland. Drone is now connected. Ignore this notification message about Wi-Fi connection. Let's open the application. Press the application icon. It gives some temperature notification every time. Read it and press yes. Open simulator. Press takeoff and confirm. This simulator is like a game. It is just to get an idea how different controls of the drone work. By default, controls work in mode 2, and I also prefer to use mode 2. In this mode, left hand side moves the drone up and down and rotate it in horizontal plane, while the right hand side of the screen moves the drone forward, backward and sideways. Now let's open the actual drone flying interface. Confirm whether your drone has propeller guards or not. Propeller guards can be bought separately as an accessory. As I don't have these on my drone right now, I will select without propeller guard option. So this is the main interface. It shows different types of information about the drone and its connection. This sign is showing the number of satellites connected with GPS of the drone. Battery percentage is shown in the top right corner. These are different setting options for camera image quality. And these are settings for video quality. These are some more setting options. For video recording, press the video icon and then press middle button to start. You can see that video recording is started and the video time can be seen on the screen. For stopping the video, press the middle button again. For taking image, press the camera icon above and then use the middle button for capturing images. As you can see, it says photo saved. On the right side, some more settings are available. Let's quickly glance these. Flight speed can be adjusted. I keep it on high setting. This is calibration setting. I will come back to it in a few seconds. Some other settings. Pressing on this icon opens images and videos that are saved in the memory card of the drone. You can select your images and videos and import it to your smartphone. You can also insert the memory card in your laptop and transfer your images and videos to the laptop directly. So this is takeoff button. And this black bar on the lower side shows information about the drone speed and height. This icon is return to home function. By pressing it, the drone will return to the place from where it took off. It will ascend to 7 meters of height before returning to home. If it is already higher than 7 meters, it will just start moving towards home. You need to calibrate your drone each time you are going to fly it in a new area. Calibration is important, as without proper calibration, your drone controls might not work properly. Press click to calibrate. Place the drone in a horizontal level plane and press yes. Rotate your drone clockwise in the horizontal plane without lifting it off the place. Keep rotating for a few seconds until the app says calibration successful. Press yes and your drone is ready for flight. You can see its live camera view. It's the adapter. Place the drone battery in the adapter. Put one end of the USB cable in the adapter and other end in any standard smartphone charger. Plug the charger in the socket and the battery charging will start. Indicator light on the adapter will first blink a few times. Then it will go red for the whole charge time. At the end, when battery is fully charged, indicator light will turn green. Battery takes about 100 minutes to get fully charged. Please be sure I am never comparing this drone with the expensive ones like DJI Spark or Mavic Pro. This is very cheaper in price as compared to those ones. So it can never be compared head to head with them. This drone must be seen individually what it is, focusing on what you get for your money and what are the major pros and cons. I'm using this drone for a few weeks now. Let's go through its major strengths and weaknesses. The image and video quality is very good. I think the camera is the best you can get for this price. Initially, I was shooting videos in 4K at 30 frames per second. But the problem was the video became quite large in size and my video editing software became very slow when I tried to edit it. So after some experimentation with different video settings in my drone, I decided to record future videos at setting of 1080 pixels and 30 frames per second. This is because recording in 1080p causes only a negligible loss in video quality as compared to 4K, whereas video size is greatly reduced, making video editing quite easier. I have seen no connection issues. Every time the drone connects easily with my Android smartphone and the connection is never lost later. The design of this drone is very beautiful and sportish. The size is very small and compact. You can fit it in your pocket too. Flying this drone is super easy and fast. It can be turned on and set for flights within seconds. You can easily control it through your smartphone without the need to carry a separate remote controller. The battery gets full charge in about 100 minutes. You get 8 extra propellers with it in case your original ones are broken somehow. The battery timing during my personal usage always remained between 5 and 7 minutes. That is quite a small time frame. You will need to make your mind in advance about where you will fly the drone and which view of a building or place you are going to capture. You might even need to go to the same place more than once in order to capture more views of it. At 30% battery, the drone starts giving you low battery notifications. It's the time you should start moving the drone to an area where drone can safely land and can be easily picked up by you. Once the battery finishes, the drone lands straight down wherever it is. Hundred meters of range is also not a big number. Be vigilant to keep the drone within your sight and range. The drone often wobbles when it is ascending or descending. Forward and backward flights are relatively smooth though. When there is a little wind, wobbling increases. Whereas in more fast winds, you should avoid flying it completely as it is very light and can easily be carried out of your control by the wind. Camera is fixed and is facing in the forward direction. It cannot be directed straight downwards, hence that view cannot be captured with it. So these are the major pros and cons. Overall, I am satisfied with my product and I think it is worth the price. I can understand with small figure in price tag, you get small figures in the specifications. Let me finish with this interesting last point. This beautiful small drone attracts eagles from far away. A few times, eagles started circling it, but fortunately they didn't grab it. Probably because of odd honeybee type sound it produces. Anyway, thanks a lot for watching. If you like the video, please share it and subscribe to my channel. Thanks again.